Hey everybody, it's Zef Zan from Entrepreneur Sensor. If you're just tuning in, today is kind of something new that I'm doing just for Thrive Thursdays. And if you can hashtag that Thrive Thursdays tips with Zef Zan. Today we're talking about a topic which is pretty new to me also. The two things that I'm going to talk about today in addition to Hangouts are Scope, which is Periscope, and Meerkat. And for some of you who are just tuning in and you're wondering, hey, who is she? So everybody, I just wanted to do a quick introduction real quickly. I am Zef Zan from Entrepreneurs at Soar. Oops, I have actually my email up right there. So that's my email address. And this is the website for Entrepreneurs at Soar. I'm not getting the right website. Here we go. Entrepreneurs@soar.com. That's our that's the website for my business. And I'm going to share real quick what the website looks like for you. Here it is on screen. I'm showing you. This is a website, and basically what I do is I have coaches, consultants, lifestyle entrepreneurs, social entrepreneurs leverage the use of Google Hangouts to create web events and videos to boost your business growth. And here's a little bit more information about working with me. Really, at the end of the day, I help you folks out there produce quick and convenient web events such as webcasts, web talk shows, and webinars to boost your business. So just wanted to have this chit chat on what we call Thrive Fitsor is that lately there's been this huge trend about online live events, right? And there's so many tools out there that you can use for your business. So I started using Google Hangouts to really take my business one step further. So here's my story and how I got started using it. For some of you folks out there just wondering, what in the world are Google Hangouts? So if you're on our Google Plus event page right now, Google Plus and Google Hangouts are, of course, owned by Google, right? So they actually are they interact and complement one another. So I just want to quickly show you here what Google Hangouts are. So as you can see, right, it's just one app for all your conversations. You can do messaging. It's some sort of video call. You can do video, as you can see right here. And there's some effects that you can do, which I can show you later. Then you can also do voice call. And like right now, what I'm doing is it's called Hangouts On Air. So we broadcast that live. So for me, when I got started using Google Hangouts, it's for a very, very good reason. Because my personal reason, I started calling it Skype on steroids, because it is. Because I actually am able to work with my talents, because at Entrepreneurs at Soar, we have a virtual internship program where we actually have talents from all around the world, the globe, to to intern with us, and we do that virtually. Before I go on real quickly, I just want to kind of share my screen. If all of you folks out there who is watching this show right now on our Google Plus page, which is right here, if you would like to ask questions, you can actually click on the Q&A there, and I will actually try to answer some of your questions during the call, all right? So there's a Q&A button that opens up to a new page, and you can actually ask me questions as we go along, and I'll get those questions. So one of the good things that we started using, like I said, was we use Google Hangouts to replace Skype, because with Skype, if many of you use Skype for your video calls, you notice that with the basic version, it's only you can only do a call on one-on-one, and you cannot have multiple people. So really, I started using that to work with my team of talents. And then later on, but with Google Hangouts, you can actually add up to 9 additional people to the call. So for instance, right now I'm hosting the call and recording the call, and I'm on live. I can bring in 9 more people on camera. So if you folks out there want to join me on camera, just write me a note right in our event page comments there, and I will give you the link to join me on the call. All right. So the fact that I use Google Hangouts is really starting to work with my team members around the world or wherever they are. And then I got inspired to do, because I said, oh my God, now I get to make a conversation, live conversation with my audience. Because what I noticed about me, and this is knowing your brand, right, is that I'm that person who's very visual, and I need to connect with people. I'm such an avid networker, but I told myself I only have 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, yes, but 24 hours a day, I do have to eat, sleep, and, you know, use the bathroom and that kind of stuff. But I said I needed to get to my audience more often and maybe faster. So I had to figure out what are the tools out there that can help me connect with my audience in real time, have a conversation, have an interaction. And then I learned about Google Hangouts, and that's how I started using it. I love Google Hangouts. Yeah, everybody, yeah. So if you're actually watching this, and if you're on Google Hangouts, make sure you hashtag Google Hangouts. Or you can also hashtag Thrive Thirst Ace. All right. So back to the story of how I started using this for my business. So I wanted to connect with more people more often and faster, right? Because we live in this social media age and technology age where I'm sure there are tools that out there that can help me connect better with my audience. And because I'm such a visual person, because I feel that, I love the idea of podcasting, but podcasts for me was, oh my God, they can only hear my voice. And sometimes, you know, there's a disconnect if you're not presenting well, right? There's just a disconnect where people cannot feel your emotions. So I figured, hey, let's be on camera. You know, I'm not shy because I'm on camera by myself anyways, right? So anyways, people can see how I talk, how I maneuver. It some sort of helps my audience pre-qualify me. So if you're a coach or consultant or independent professional, if you want to connect better with your audience, this is the way to do it. Okay, go live. So people can see your Italian hands. Me being Malaysian, I call them Malaysians, have Malaysian hands too. So, you know, culturally, our hands move. So I think my audience get to see my authentic self, or whatever that definition of authentic to you is, right? Being real in real time, live, and having a conversation. So I've been using Google Hangouts for, I think, close to about 2 years now, because I started a web show called Creative Chat Cafe. It is a lifestyle, is a web show for lifestyle entrepreneurs where we give ideas, you know, discuss experiences and share tips to help lifestyle entrepreneurs achieve success. So we started doing Creative Chat Cafe probably about a year and a half ago. So we dabbled with Google Hangouts and Hangouts On Air in May 2013, I believe. So we started doing that, and we started in a exact location because at that time, Entrepreneurs at Soar had a networking group on meetup.com. So we started meeting in person, but then I said, you know, I wanted people who could not attend the event to watch us on, I'm just going to fix my camera a little bit, to watch us on online and maybe connect and have an interaction with us. So we started bringing the camera into the live room, you know, where we have our meetings and broadcasted our meetings. And then I said, oh my God, I had blocked so many equipment. I have this access to this video call platform, which is really cool. You can really do it anywhere, even if you're on your toilet seat. You know what I mean? So I keep on telling people it's a convenience, it's a simplicity of doing this live shows. Now, now that I'm so hype up about Google Hangouts and Hangouts On Air, what I've noticed recently are two new apps, live video apps, that are up and coming and really blooming. And there's some really, really great people out there who are doing a great job on these live video apps. So I want to share two that I have been checking out, and I did one on one of them recently. So I'm still learning the other one. So I'm going to quickly share my screen and share you what I'm talking about. So if you have any just a little stuck there with my internet connection. You can write your comments right here and send me your questions, all right? Or you can also click on the Q&A. It opens up in a new page. So one of the two apps that I started checking out is Periscope, all right? You can actually download the app on your app store, on the Apple App Store and also Google Play. And the other one is called Meerkat. I don't know if you have checked it out, but they both live stream videos. So the videos go live, right? So Meerkat apparently had come out first. I have not played around with Meerkat a lot, but I have been on a few Meerkat live stream videos where I sat in some presentations about, you know, how the people are using the app. So here's Periscope. So I did last week our team meeting on Periscope, and there's this, if you access the streams on your desktop, you can find people doing like the funniest things. And of course, some are for business, some are just like, hey, my yogi baby kicking. I mean, you know, this is what I wanted to talk about and address, that we live in a world right now that is so driven by live videos, with live web events. People want to know what's going on because everything is on demand, right? So people can really go and watch and connect you whenever you go online. So just like what I'm doing right now on Hangouts On Air, there is a place, there is my own channel. So if you watch a specific episode on your TV that you love, it could be, I don't know, NCIS or whatever, you know, you can go to Fox, NBC, ABC, right, to watch that specific episode of your favorite show. Now, going on live video is kind of similar for your business. So it's kind of on demand. You go live videos. You can do on demand later. You can go live and connect with your audience. And I think that's what our audience want these days in our business, because it makes it real for them, especially if you're building an online business. They don't know who you are, right? In order to connect with you, they kind of need to know, God, who is she, right? What does she do? And how do I know if she's a great fit to work with me? Or how can I know if she's a great fit to be my coach or mentor? So many people are using this platform, the live videos or live web events like Hangouts, Periscope, and Meerkat. So you can hashtag all three, Hangouts, Periscope, and Meerkat, to connect with your audience better in lifetime, so that their audience can actually interact with them, right? So one of the great things that I've learned about both Periscope app and also the Meerkat, so I'm going to share my screen again. With the Periscope app, right, so when you go live and you stream live, I don't know if you can watch this, but I'm going to try and click on this and see if you can see this. I may not be able to. Okay, hang on. So I don't seeing it, but I may have to change to a different. Here you go. So here is the. So what we're really doing, we're watching this girl on Periscope, right? And she's scoping. And what people do is you see the hearts right here. The idea of Periscope is really to get people to like you or give you heart or people are harvesting hearts, because that indicates that people like your live streamed video, whatever that you're doing. It could be makeup or jewelry. So as you can see, people are coming in through this Periscope live stream to, I'm gonna shut her off on audio because it's, I'm hearing her speak while I speak too, so it's kind of clashing. So as you can see, she's talking, and here are some of the hearts that people are giving her, because she's probably, her content is really awesome, right? So they're giving her hearts and she's talking, but there's no audio on it. You can just type in your conversation. So I'm gonna try another one and see if, I can share with you some of the best Periscopers out there. If you're familiar with Instagal, Subi Zimmerman, she's on it. And I've been following a couple more people, and this 22-year-old kid from Ohio who is an online marketer, who's 22 years old. He goes to school. He's taking his master's right now. He's also an online marketer, and he's killing it on Scope. So I'm gonna try to find his feed, because what's about to happen is people are there's in September, there will be a New York Scope Week, and they're trying to get or vote for the best speaker that they want to see at New York Scope Week, and Zach Spuckler has been one of those people. Let me see if I can find him here. If I can see him. Oh, one great thing about Periscope is Periscope was bought over by Twitter. So it's actually connected to your Twitter account. So whenever you go live, what's great about Periscope is you can actually tweet it out and have people follow you. So that's a great thing about Periscope, is like in the now, in real time, and have a conversation with your audience. I'm gonna see if I can find, let's see if I can find Zach Spuckler in here. So, because I would really love for all of you who are thinking about learning Scope, you can actually tune in to Zach's Heart Hustle Nation, as he calls it, to learn more about Periscope. If I could find it, give me a second, find a way to get the stream for Zach Spuckler. So I don't think I can, there's a way to do it on the desktop to Google, find for the people, unless I scroll down and see if everybody is on doing a live show right now. If they're not, they're probably on. Okay, so I'm actually going to a different one. I'm going to really segue to Meerkat, because it's easier to find them on Meerkat right here, because they have the tab to show you the top Meerkats. So Meerkat app is similar to the Periscope app. It's a live video stream, a live stream video app, and you can really just click it on your tablet or on your smartphones and go. You know, you don't have to be on your desktop like Google Hangouts to record it. You have to be on a desktop or on your laptop or computer. So I'm going to show you real quick the screen for Meerkat, and here's what it is, what it looks like. So here's the Meerkat streams. All right, you can go to meerkatstreams.com, and then there's this page that will show you everybody that's on live right now on Meerkat, and you can see how many people are watching. All right, and here is a tab for top cat. So as you can see, right, so here are the top people on Meerkats. Meerkats are great, and Meerkats, I think about earlier this week, launched two new features that will allow you, and one of the feature is actually embedding it on your website. So Jeff Goldberg right here, I've seen him on on Meerkat, or the Periscopers are talking about him also. So I want to go down a little bit more to show you one of the people that you should be following if you're on Meerkat or Periscope, because he is on both. All right. So I think he's listed at number 30 here. Brian Fanzo, you can go there. As you can see, the score right here, he goes by iSocial Fans. So his score right here is 120,204. That's how many people have liked his presentations or his live stream videos, right? You can always go there and go and follow him on Meerkat and see if he's live or not. Okay, here's a safe stream that I hope you can actually, oh, I don't have my safe stream here. But anyways, you can follow him on Meerkat and Periscope at iSocial Fans, all right? And he gives tips on online marketing, and also now he's doing a Periscope and also Meerkatting about both Periscope and Meerkat, how to build your business using both apps. So my thought process for all of you folks out there, I'm not going to go long on this. I just wanted to show you what's up and coming. And next week, I'm going to do a live Hangouts On Air event talking about what's this up and coming new trend about going live, live web events, live video, why it is important for you to even try it for your business, okay? How you use to grow them. So next week, Wednesday, we'll put out all the information for the Hangouts On Air event so you can join me. And perhaps if you want to come and join me in the call on camera, let me know. I can send you the link and have a conversation about the live web events, the live videos, why it is important for all of us to at least give it a try. And also, if you enjoy the platforms going live, build a strategy around them so that you can actually boost your business growth. And this is what we are doing at Entrepreneurs at SOAR. So I started on the journey really just wanting to work with, you know, talents, my talents in my team, or even my affiliate partners that I collaborate with through a video call platform, because I get to see the person, I get to engage in real time and have a conversation, right? So I wanted to do that, and that was important to me to connect with my audience, especially in such a cool platform like, you know, like the technology platform. So I started using Google Hangouts, but now there are so many other tools that literally can help you go live and connect with your audience, like these two apps that I've talked about, Periscope app and also the Meerkat app. You can download both on you know, iTunes store, Apple store, and also the Google Play stores. Download that, give them a try, right? And see how you like it. You have to know if it fits your business and fits your lifestyle, all right? So the three differences between the differences between Google Hangouts On Air, when I go live this way, I set everything up on the desktop and I go live. So I'm just gonna check my questions just in case if there is anyone asking questions out there. So if you have any questions, make sure you send them to me, click on that. If not, after this show, you can still ask questions on our event page. Again, I'm gonna show you where it is real quickly. If you're not joining us live right now, after the show, this conversation, you can still go to our page, right? You'll go to Entrepreneurs at SOAR and you'll look for this event. Do you Hangout Scope or are you a Meerkat? And you can have a conversation with us here, okay? So one of the biggest thing about the differences between going live on your smartphone or tablets and also going live on Google Hangouts is Google Hangouts On Air, in order for you to go live and record it, for you to host a call, you have to be on a computer. That's the only way to do it. Other people who join you on the call can be on their mobile devices, whether it's tablet or their smartphones. But with, and you can have a two-way conversation. That means your attendees can have a conversation with you. If you've seen my show, Creative Chat Cafe, you have seen me bring guests and my co-hosts into the show. And usually at this side of, somewhere around here, in the video, you will see like a few more people and them on camera. That's the beauty of Google Hangouts. You can see the picture of the other person and, you know, have a conversation just like if you're in a coffee shop and talking to them. Now with Periscope app and Meerkat, it's a one-way camera. However, your audience can still engage with you by just typing in, you know, their conversation there, give you a heart. The way they give you a heart or like you is just tap on the screen. It's really easy. And, you know, you can literally not overthink about, oh my God, how do I set it up? You know, if I'm on the go, all you have to do is get the app going, right? Start your broadcast and boom, you just have people joining you on your live stream video. That's the beauty of it because, you know, it's really real time. You can have that connection with your audience and have a conversation. How do you use this for business, right? One of the greatest things about going live, whether it's a web event where you create a web event or you can actually do a live video, there are so many ideas of how you can use it. So what I'll do is probably one of our Google Hangout session, I would actually create an event where you can come in and have a conversation with me on camera, on a call, where we can all brainstorm and give ideas to one another on how we all can use this for our business. They're all great tools, but you just need to know which ones work best for you because it can be overwhelming with all these tools that you have, right? And which one do I go? And just because a few people really excelled very well on Periscope, I need to be on Periscope. But think about it, right? If Periscope is very on the demand, in real time, and from what I understand and have learned from some of the best scopers is, here's what Periscope live videos, what will happen to your videos. When you broadcast them live, they're available for replay 24 hours after you go live. So basically people who can watch you live can always watch the replays, right? But you only have 24 hours. So some of the best Periscopers like Zach Spuckler, Sue B. Zimmerman, and Alex Petit from the UK. So follow them all. They're really great. They have really great content sharing information on how you can use Periscope. And they kind of walk you through the processes on how you can use them, these apps to build your business growth. So, oh God, I lost my train of thoughts. But anyway, so with Periscope, you can actually do that replay. Now, those replay are only available 24 hours post the broadcast, right? So the best Periscopers have said, in order for you to get tracking and people liking and following you, followers especially, right? I'm not going to think much about the followers. I'll tell you why in a minute. So you want people to follow you on Periscope as you do your live shows and get hearts and you harvest those hearts, right? You farm those hearts. You need to at least be on Periscope almost every day. Yes, every day, okay? And it's technically if you can get on every 24 hours, right? Of course, if that's a want, that's a will, that's a way, right? We're all busy people. But that's the sort of tracking that you want to do on Periscope. And the same thing with Meerkat, because it's like your own TV channel, your own time. You come up with your content, whether you're a health coach, you're talking about, you know, how to eat right, or if you're a person who does jewelry and want to show how your jewelry can be worn 10, 20 different ways, you can do that all live. But you kind of need to know that in order to get tracking on both Periscope and Meerkat, you kind of have to do your live broadcast almost like every 24 hours. That's like the least. Zach Spuckler and Alex Petit, I feel that I'm getting notification on my phones like every other hour, but they're killing it. They're awesome. They're giving great content. You need to follow them. So I'm just going to go to Zach Spuckler's heart. So he goes by Hearts. Here you go. So right now, you can go to hotsoul.com/periscope. He is actually giving away a download on find your topic, your hot topic scope workbook. So if you're thinking of using scope for your business, this workbook will help you to figure out the topics that you can do on your life scope, on your life scopes. So basically, this is Zex Buckler. He calls himself a Periscope master or junkie, and that's the truth, because I think he goes on he goes on like every other hour or something. And it's, for me, I think it's a lot for my schedule. But like I said, you need to find your groove and find your poison, whether it's Hangouts On Air, whether it's Periscope, whether it's Meerkat, to kind of use and build, use them or use one of them in your business, in your marketing strategy, build a strategy around it. It's just not about going live and have a conversation, because you know that would be a waste of time if you just go on. Yes, you'll have the followers, you'll have people give you hearts, but you need to know, where do you take that that live video, and how do you use it in your business so that you can grow your business, right? That's the reason why we do these things. It is a marketing strategy, yes, but figure out that strategy. So as we go on in July, I may do a few more Hangouts On Air event where I'll have a discussion on how you can use different tools and what you can do as far as leveraging web events such as webcasts, web shows, and webinars to grow your business. We'll give you some, you know, tips, ideas, and also strategies. And I would love to get your feedback and learn how you would like to learn more about, you know, leveraging web events, webinars, and webcasts in your business. So I'm almost about time here. I know it's half an hour, but I just want to really, really make sure that I share this information with you, because this is pretty new for me too, because oh my God, there's so many things when it comes to tools, gadgets, and technology, right? There's so many things, and so many people are sharing them online, but you need to find the right people to share that information. I hope we can be your peep for that information, and also send you, if you're really, really interested in learning more about Periscope and Meerkat, you know, from time to time I'll send more information of some of the best scopers. I hope I get to go to the New York Scope Week, with which is I think September 22nd and 23rd this year. But I hope that, you know, if you have any ideas that you want to talk about as far as how you can bring that idea into a live web event or live video, we definitely need to have a conversation. Maybe another Hangouts On Air event. Until then, I just want to say thank you. Let me just quickly check, just in case anyone send me questions on the page, just in case, right? Because you never know. Let me see. Okay, I'm just seeing if there's, so there is a question. Somebody asked me, when hosting on a platform, just Google Hangouts and Periscope, how vital is it to advertise your live web show? And how do you advertise these live web shows? Okay, so like anything else that we do, right? It's an event, because when you go live, it is an event. You're talking, whether it's a conference, seminar, or a networking event, or even when you go out and eat, right? It is an event. So I suggest to you, in order to connect and promote your event, advertise your event, of course you can advertise through social media, and you can actually do word of mouth at your networking events. But the most important thing is, yes, the way we do it, the way we advertise it, and we all know social media is some sort of a word of mouth marketing, right? On steroids, I call it, because everything's just a click buttons away. So what we do, normally what we do is we have event pages and share event pages so that people can go to those event pages to watch it. So ideally what I did with today's event was create a Google Plus event page, right? And have people, I mean, invite people to the event and they all RSVP. Facebook has it too, but the only great thing about the Google Plus event is the video goes live on the page. So I'm going to quickly show again the page. So this is what this is what we do at Entrepreneurs at Soar. If we host a live Google Hangouts event, which is actually called Hangouts On Air event, that is the live one and that you can record. It says here live. So what we do is we create an event page. This is at our event page, right? And here's the video that is parked, and anybody who comes to this page, so this could be my ABC channel or Fox channel or NBC, however you see it. So I park them, I park the video in the Google Events page, because you are able to do that on a Google Plus Events page. And here are the details of the event, right? And what it is about, what time. And here are the people that, have been invited to the event, and they can watch the show. And all they have to do is click on that play button and also watch the show and have a conversation with us. There's two ways for our audience to interact in real time with the host of the show or people on the show. Usually the host, whoever is hosting this event, you can type something in here, hello, right? And have a conversation, because we check that the messages during the show. Or you can actually click on this page right here. I'm going to show you if I'm on a different profile and see how that looks from a, because I'm on the profile, this profile that I'm showing you right now is from our Entrepreneurs at Soar page. So the profile that is hosting the call right now. So I can't really show you the exact, or what it looks like. Okay. This is from my personal profile on Google Hangouts. I'm sorry, on Google Plus. So if I click on that, right? So it looks like I'm watching this. So what I could do is actually click on that button here, and it changes to a different, as you can see, it changes to a different, a different screen. Okay, so if you're watching this right now, this is probably what you're getting. You can have a conversation with people who are hosting the call. See the question mark right here? I'm sorry, not question mark, the grid right here. Click on that, and that's a Q&A button that you can ask the host of the show. So that's the great thing about it, is you can actually have a conversation. That's how we market and advertise and promote our Hangouts On Air event, because it's easier to just share it online, right? You create a page where you can just at a click of a button share with everybody throughout the world. It takes you 2 seconds maybe to just click on, you know, share or plus one onto your home stream, and hopefully ask your friends or your connections in your network to share the event. So that's one of the great ways that we share events. I hope a little bit of the content today has given you some ideas on how you too can start leveraging tools that can help you create live videos and live web events like Google Hangouts or Hangouts On Air, Periscope app and Meerkat app. And I too am still learning about Periscope and Meerkat. I think I'm more inclined to use Periscope, but hey, who knows? I might use both, because with Meerkat, like I said, you can actually embed, say for instance, if you're going live on your smartphone, if you go to your desktop, you can literally take that embed code, which is the newest feature that Meerkat added last week. You can take that embed code and put it on your website or web page, and people can watch it on your website. So, which is generally really, really cool, because we do want people to go to our websites, right? So folks, I'm way past my time. So I hope if you have any comments or feedback, please do let us know. Go to our events page, or even just go to entrepreneurs.sort.com or you right here, my website right here. Ooh, my hand's going the wrong way. So connect with us on Facebook, on YouTube, on, let me see if I can get any information right here for our pet. So, all right. So if you're on a website, that's our website, and you can connect with me on YouTube right here. If I can, there you go. I'm on YouTube, I'm Zef Zan, and we also have a different channel for Entrepreneurs at Soar. You can find this video on that channel. I'm also on LinkedIn. I'm sorry, Google Plus right here, Zef Zan. I'm on LinkedIn, also Zef Zan, Twitter. And if you're on about.me, I'm also Zef Zan on about.me. Okay, so folks, thank you for joining in, tuning in. If you have any questions, comments, feedback, on any of the content that I talked about today, I would be more than happy to answer any of your questions and would love to hear your feedback. Maybe there's some other things that you would like me to share in our next event. I think the next Hangout On Air event, which is next week, Wednesday, I believe it's Wednesday, July the 8th. I'm doing a live Hangouts On Air event talking about what's up with this new trend of everybody going live and how you can benefit this for your business. I'm going to give you 5 steps, I think, and look out for our promotions of our event pages. Looking forward to see you on the next Hangouts On Air call. Have a great day, everybody, and have a great 4th of July weekend. Bye-bye.